Hello viewers, welcome back on Alpa Active Learning. For better learning experience, keep watching and keep growing. But before that, do like, share my videos, and if you have not subscribed, do subscribe Standard 8. Science, lesson number 14, we are going to solve sums on measurement of heat. To solve this sum, you need to know some necessary formula. That is, heat required for temperature change is mass of water into change in temperature. Remember, here mass of water is in gram and temperature is in 0 degree Celsius. The second formula is relation between the temperature in Fahrenheit and that of Celsius. This is F minus 32 upon 9 is equal to C upon 5. The next formula, to convert Kelvin or Celsius. So it is K is equal to C plus 273.15. The next is difference in the length here. Is equal to lambda into L1 into delta T, where delta T means difference in temperature and delta L is different in length. Second is L2 is equal to L1 into the bracket 1 plus lambda into delta T. This is also used for linear expansion. For aerial expansion, A2 is equal to A1 into 1 plus sigma into delta T. For a volumetric expansion, V2 is equal to V1 into the bracket 1 plus beta into delta T. Remember, the heat required or heat given for an object is M into C into delta T, where C is specific heat. And for all this thing, remember the conversion.
How much kilogram heat is equal to 1000 grams.
The temperature of 1.5
so let's go
water from 15 degrees Celsius to 45 degrees Celsius. Give the answer in calories as well as in joule. Let's understand. We have water of 1.5 kg. That means mass is equal to 1.5 kg. We'll convert into grams, so 1500. Now we want to change the temperature from 15 to 45, right? So the difference will be 45 minus 15 is 30. But to change this, we must provide some heat. So the formula used is heat required for temperature change is equal to mass of water into change in temperature. Now put the values. Now 15 threes are 45 followed by 3 zeros is your final answer. So 45,000 calorie is the heat required. Now to convert into joule, we must multiply calorie by 4.18 joule. So on multiplication, we get the answer 1,88,100 joule. Now, if the temperature of water changes by 10 degree Celsius on giving 300 calorie of heat, what is the mass of water? Very simple. Let's find out what is given. The given is heat given to water is 300 calorie. Calorie is a unit. Now we want to find out the mass of water M and the temperature changed is 10 degrees Celsius. So we know the formula. Amount of heat given is mass of water into change in temperature. Just substitute correctly. Very easy. 300 is equal to M into 10. Divide this. You will get M is equal to 30 gram. Write your answer in word. The mass of water is 30 grams. Next sum, how much will the temperature of 68 degree Fahrenheit be in Celsius and Kelvin? So what is given? The temperature in Fahrenheit is given 68. We need to find what is in Celsius and in Kelvin. So recall the formula. Yes, It is F minus 32 upon 9 is equal to C upon 5. Now substitute 68 as F. 68 minus 32 is 36. Rest thing as it is. Now please, 9 fours are 36 and cross multiply, C is 20. Once you know C is 20, that is temperature in Celsius, it is easy to find by using this formula. K is equal to C plus 273.15 in Kelvin. Put the value, add them. So the value of here of K is 293.15. So we can write the temperature in Celsius is 20 degrees Celsius and that in Kelvin is 293.15 K. At what temperature will its value be same in Celsius and Fahrenheit? Now, no other values are given, children. So, we assume that F is equal to C. So, again, the same formula. Now, wherever F is there, you can write C. Substituting this, C minus 32 upon 9 is equal to C upon 5. Best way, cross multiply. So, C minus 32 into 5 is equal to 9 into C. Now, here, open the bracket. And multiply, so 5 into C minus this will be 160 is equal to 9C. Now solve the equation. This will be 9C minus 5C, 4C is equal to minus 160. So C is equal to minus 40 degree. And hence we can write the temperature in Celsius and in Fahrenheit will be same at minus 40 degree. Okay. The next sum. What must be the temperature in Fahrenheit so that it will be twice its value in Celsius? Now, understand? Here we want it should be double than the Celsius. Temperature in Fahrenheit should be double. So let the temperature in Celsius be T since we don't know. So the Fahrenheit will be 2T. Now, we know the formula F minus 32 upon 9 is equal to C upon 5. We substitute the value. Here it will be 2T minus 32 upon 9 and C is equal to T. Cross multiply. So 5 into the bracket 2T minus 32 is equal to 90. So now 5 twos are 10T minus 160 is equal to 90. On solving, we get T is equal to 160 degree. Now, once T is 160, it is easy to find Fahrenheit because it is 2T. So, 2 into 160, that is 320 degree Fahrenheit. Now, two substances A and B have specific heat C and 2C respectively. If A and B are receives Q and 4Q amount of heat, the change in the temperature is the same. If the mass of A is M, what is the mass of B? Let's understand that we have two substances, right? A and B. Now for both the substances, we don't know the mass. So let us for body A, let the mass is small m. For the body B, we assume the mass is capital M. Now for A, the heat given is Q and for B, it is 4Q. So here, most important thing is the change in the temperature is T is same. That means we are giving the heat till they achieve the same change in temperature. So for that, we'll use the formula. Amount of the heat given is Q into M into C into delta T, where C is a specific heat. So for the body A, formula will be M into C into T. Okay. Now for the body B, using the same formula, now here heat given is 4Q into 2C into capital T. Now how to proceed further? So here in the first equation, we write the value of T as Q upon MC. And this will substitute in the equation number 2. So wherever T is there, we write Q upon MC. Now look at here. Q and Q, both the side get cancelled. C and C get cancelled. So what is remaining here? Yes, if you cross multiply, 4m is equal to 2m. Further dividing, we will get m is equal to 2m. That means the mass of the B is double the mass of A. When a substance having mass 3 kg receives 600 calories of heat, its temperature increases by 10 degrees Celsius. What is the specific heat of the substance? So let us first find out our data. We need to find out the specific heat of substance. So we assume, let the specific heat be C. The mass is given 3 kg children. So we write M is equal to 3 kg. That changed to 3000 gram. The 600 calorie heat. So Q is equal to 600. And the temperature difference is 10 degrees Celsius. That is delta T. So the formula used is Q is equal to M into C into delta T. Now just substitute the values. 600 is equal to 3000 into C into 10. So very easy children, 3000 into 10 is 30,000, right? So 600 is equal to divided by 30,000. Two zeros get cancelled. We will get C is equal to 1 upon 50, that is 0.02. Okay. A bridge is made from 20 meter long iron rods. At temperature 18 degrees Celsius, the distance between two rods is 0.4 centimeter. Up to what temperature will the bridge be in good shape? So here the length of the iron rod is 20 meter, that is 2000 centimeter. Distance between them is 0.4 centimeter. And lambda is given 11.5 into 10 raised to minus 6. Now the bridge will be in proper and good shape until both rods expand by 0.2 cm. So let the increase in the temperature be T. The initial temperature is 18 degree. So difference will be delta T, that is T minus 18. Now we write the formula. Put the value of delta T here as T minus 18. Lambda is given, length is 2000 and difference in the length is 0.4 cm. Now to solve this, 0.4 divided by 2000 into 11.5 into 10 raised to minus 6, we keep T minus 18 on one side. Now first eliminate the decimal between 0.4 and 11.5 and bring this 10 raised to minus 6 in the numerator. So this will be 4 into 10 raised to 6 upon 2000 into 115 is equal to T minus 80. Now further how to solve this? Let's see. 10 raised to 6. So we'll write here 4 into 10 raised to 6. So write 10 legs divided by 2000. Into 115. We first cancel these three zeros. So remaining is 4000 upon 2. That is 2000. If we divide them. So 2000 divided by 115. You will get 17.40. So the 17.40 is equal to T minus 18. Getting the value of T as 18 plus 17.4. Just solving the equation. You will get the final answer 35.4 degree. So up to 35.4 degree, even if the temperature is raised, the bridge will be in the good condition.